Hi everyone, in this framer tutorial we're going to create this great looking testimonials section with sliding testimonials and background animations. Of course, this much of animated elements can be too much in real world design, but since we are creating these to practice, it is going to serve perfectly for that purpose. So let's get started. As always, I don't have anything but some stand color styles and an empty stack. We're gonna start by copying and pasting some placeholder or lorem ipsum text for our testimonial component. I'm gonna paste it and make sure that its text style is set to body, and I'm gonna make its width 500 pixels, and I'm gonna leave its height as fit content. Then I'm gonna right click to my text element, select add stack from the drop down, and go into the layers tab. I'm gonna rename the stack testimonial, and then I'm going to remove the fill of my stack. Then I'm going to create a frame which is going to be a border between the testimonial text and the info underneath. While I'm in testimonial stack, I'm gonna create the frame and press in the right arrow key. Actually, I'm gonna change the order, and I'm gonna make it width 50 pixels, and height is going to be 3. Then I'm going to make its radius also 3, and I'm going to make its color accent from the color styles. Now we can start changing our testimonial stack properties. I'm gonna change its width and height to fit content and make its direction vertical. I'm gonna keep its distribute property at center, change a line to start, and I'm gonna make its gap 14. Now we can create the text element or the name part of our testimonial. So I'm gonna duplicate the testimonial text, and by pressing the down arrow, I'm gonna place it under the border and change its content to a placeholder name. And then I'm going to change its text style to name under my styles. Now we can create the final part of our testimonials, which is going to be position and company. I'm just going to duplicate the name text and change its style to position company. And finally, change its content to, again, a placeholder text. That makes sense. Of course, name and the company texts are using the general gap we have for our testimonial stack, right? To change the space between them individually, I'm going to select both of them and add them to a separate stack and make the new stack's gap 0. Now that we have the static structure and all elements that we need for our testimonial component, we can just turn it into a component by right clicking and selecting create component. I'm gonna leave the name as testimonial. Now we can assign variables for each piece of content in our testimonial component. While in testimonial component screen, I'm going to select the text part of our testimonial, and under the text section on the right panel, I'm going to click the plus button at the left of the content property, and hovering over create variables, I'm going to select formatted text, since we want our user to be able to format text and add links, etc. when required. We are selecting formatted text instead of the plain one, and I'm going to leave the name as text. Now I'm gonna do the same for the name part of our testimonial component. After selecting it, I'm just going to click the plus icon left of the content property and hover over create variable. This time we can just select the plain text to keep things simple, right? And I'm going to change its name to name to be descriptive. Lastly, we're gonna assign a variable to the position and company part of our testimonial. So I'm going to select plain text and change the name to position and company, and leave the rest of the settings as they are. Now that we have our component variables, we can paste our sample testimonials and name and position company that I created with ChatGPT, right? So I'm gonna double click to an empty space on the canvas while I'm in component screen to go back to the home screen. And starting from the first one, I'm going to copy and paste the sample testimonials. Under the testimonial component properties, I'm going to click edit content next to the text property. I'm going to paste the sample. Do the same for also name and company properties. Then I'm going to duplicate the existing testimonial and continue pasting the sample content. Now we can insert our slideshow component, right? So I'm going to click the insert button at the top left. I'm going to type slideshow in the search box and drag it into my stack. I'm going to make its width 550 and height 346. Something to keep in mind, since slideshow's width and height needs to be fixed, we determine these values considering the optimal size for our testimonials. Now we can connect our testimonials to our slideshow, right? So I'm going to drag connections to each of the testimonials I have on the right, and I'm going to move. Actually, we can just enter a temporary top padding. We need 196 pixels of top padding to simulate the end position of our testimonials. So I entered that temporary padding, and now we can customize our slideshow properties, right? So I'm gonna double click to it to quickly view the slideshow component properties, and since it was too fast, I'm going to make its interval 3 seconds and make the draggable yes, and I'm going to add a left padding of 24 pixels. I'm going to click the clipping and make the fade yes, and I'm going to enter a 10% of fade for a nice transition while our testimonials are sliding. And I'm going to hide the arrows, since we made our testimonials draggable, which is more practical. Lastly, I'm going to customize the dots to make their color interaction in our color styles. Now we can test it. Yeah, the intervals, transition, and all looks nice. We can browse our testimonials by either dragging or using the dot buttons at the bottom. Now we can start creating the background animation, right? So I'm going to click the insert button at the top left and type material in the search box and drag the material components to my canvas. Then I'm going to view its properties and select in the search. I'm going to type code to have the quotation icon. Then I'm going to rotate it to have a opening quotation mark, then change its color to accent from my color styles, and style is going to be rounded. And I'm going to lock its aspect ratio and make its width 136. And I'm going to right click the code icon and select add frame from the drop down and name the frame BG animation, and remove the frame's background fill. Then I'm going to select the material icon and I'm going to center it. Then while the BG animation frame is selected, I'm going to make its width 784 and height 290. Then I'm going to move the icon to the top left of the frame. For our second icon in the background animation, I'm going to duplicate the existing quote icon, drag it to the bottom right of the frame, and rotate it back to its original position. We can actually make it easily under the transform section by entering 0 for the rotate property. Then our BG animation frame is ready to be made a component, right? So I'm going to do that, leaving its name as BG animation. Then I'm going to make the opacity changes in our component. In the first variant of our component, left icon's opacity is going to be 0.3. And bottom right is going to be 0.1. Now we can create the second variant that we need for our background animation, right? So after selecting the variant 1, I'm going to click to the plus button next to it and flip the icon's opacities by this time changing the top left's opacity to 0.1 and bottom right's to 0.3. Now that we have two variants, we can create a transition, right? So I'm gonna drag a connection from the second variant to the first one. Trigger is going to be appear, and delay is going to be 3 seconds. And since I want this transition to be looped, I'm going to select the cycle, and then to change the duration of our transition, I'm going to go to the transition property under the styles and click in the ease tab. I'm going to select time to 1 second. Now we can define the exact same transition from our first variant to the second one, right? Appear, 3 seconds, equals, duration is going to be 1 second. So we can go back to the home screen and drag our BG animation component to our stack, right? So I'm gonna do that. Obviously, we needed to have absolute position, and to position it correctly, I'm gonna enter 85 as top value, and as I see it, it's perfectly centered horizontally. Now we can test how things look. So as you see, our background animation works while our testimonials are sliding, but we cannot drag our testimonials. Although the bottom navigation works, we cannot browse our testimonials by dragging. So we're gonna add Z index to fix that. As I see it, our background animation has already a Z index of 1. So all we need to do is, even though we can change the layer order in the layers panel, it's not going to affect. As you see, we need to add a Z index that is bigger than 1 for our slideshow component to fix that. So in the styles section, I'm going to click the plus button and add a Z index property, and enter something like 5 for our slideshow Z index. So as you see, now it works perfectly. While our background animation works, we can perfectly use the drag feature for our testimonials. Now we can start creating the sliding icons at the top and the bottom, right? While I'm in desktop stack, I'm going to create a frame, and I'm going to name it icons top, and I'm going to carry it to the top of my content, and I'm going to delete the temporary padding that we entered before, and I'm going to change my icon stop frames properties. I need its width to fill and top to be 34 pixels. Since the background of the icon stop frame is going to serve as a mask for our sliding icons, we need to fill its background with a gradient that fades out from the center. So while my icon stop frame is selected, I'm going to click the input box next to fill property under the styles, and I'm gonna select the gradient tab, and while I'm in linear gradient tab, I'm going to rotate the gradient tool to create a horizontal gradient, and then I'll make sure that I select the color dot on the right to change its color to icon sticker BG from my color styles. And again, since we need a gradient that fades out from the center, I'm going to drag the icon sticker BG color dot to the middle horizontally, and then I'm going to add another color dot, which is going to be just a transparent dot, and I'm gonna make also the color dot on the right transparent to have that horizontal gradient that fades out from the center, as I said. Time to create the icon that we're going to make slide with ticker, right? So I'm going to simply copy the material icon that I have in my BG animation component. Then I'm going to paste it to an empty space on my canvas. Then I'm going to lock its aspect ratio and make its width 30 pixels. And lastly, I'm going to change its color to my background color, since we need to fade them out while they are sliding. Now we need to make the icon a component. I'm gonna right click the opening quote icon that we've just copied and select add frame from the drop down, and I'm gonna name the frame ticker icon. Then I'm going to remove its fill, and lastly I'm going to turn it into a component, leaving its name as it is. Then I'm going to select the material component, and I'm going to center it, and then I'm going to make its opacity 0.5. Then I'm going to select the variant one and make it both width and height 60 pixels to help to space our icons evenly in the ticker. Then I'm going to create another variant and I'm gonna name it close quote, and then transform the icon to turn it into a close quotation mark. Then I'm going to go back to home screen and make also required width and height change here by changing ticker icon components both width and height to 60 pixels. Now we can insert our ticker components, right? So I'm going to type ticker in the search box. After clicking the insert button, I'm gonna drag the ticker component to the top in the icon's top frame, and I'm gonna pin it to the top, making its top position 0, and I need it to be full width, which in this case 1200 pixels. I'm going to of course horizontally center it and make its height equal to the icon's top background. Of course I'm gonna make sure that in the icon's top frame, since we're going to space our icons in the ticker with the size of our component, I'm going to make ticker components both gap and padding 0. And I'm going to drag a connection of my ticker component to the icon and test how it looks. As I see it, it is too fast. I'm gonna make its speed 10%. Let's see that again. Yeah, I think this looks much better. Now we can create our icon's bottom ticker, right? So I'm going to clone the icon's top frame and make its position absolute and pin it to the bottom, make its bottom value 0, and change the desktop stack's height to 600 to adjust the spacing. And then of course I'm going to rename the frame icon's bottom. After selecting the ticker at the bottom, I'm going to remove the child item it has, and then I'm going to create the ticker icon that I'm going to use for the ticker at the bottom. After cloning it, I'm going to rename it ticker icon bottom, and then I'm going to change its variant to close quote. Lastly, I'm going to connect the ticker at the bottom to the close quote icon. Now we can test the whole thing. As I see it, everything works perfectly. We can navigate our testimonials either with the navigation at the bottom or by dragging. And our top, background and bottom animations work perfectly. Hope you liked the tutorial. Be sure to subscribe and turn the notifications on if you haven't already. And don't forget to also check my other tutorials. So see you in the next one.